We have come to the United Kingdom of Great Britain as part of an international tour and mission to meet with senior religious leaders, heads of state and politicians. We have been mandated by all the church leaders in the Holy Land to share our story and raise awareness of the challenges we are facing as a Christian community. Recently, we have seen the emergence of a trend that threatens to undermine the Christian presence and destabilize the peace of the holy city of Jerusalem. The status quo, inverted comma, rules that has guaranteed the rights of Jews, Christians, and Muslims to live, flourish, and thrive together in Jerusalem for centuries is in a grave danger. This code that has safeguarded our religious freedoms and provided access to the most holy places for all people is being dangerously undermined. If we do not act soon, it will be too late, and the outcome will be catastrophic. Were it to be passed, this bill would be in clear violation of the status quo and arguably numerous international treaties. Furthermore, as we sit here today, a group of radical settlers are working to push Christians out of Jerusalem. Before, we stood silent, bearing patient witness to a harsh campaign against us and against our church. Every day we face false accusations, suspicion, and slander. Our detractors target our heritage and our integrity. Today, our calling and commitment to the Lord means we can accept this no longer, and this has led us to break our silence and simply say, enough is enough. 40 misled members of the Knesset, that is to say the Israeli parliament, last July signed a proposed bill for debate in the Israeli parliament, which, if passed, will severely restrict the rights of the churches to deal freely and independently with their lands, and more worryingly, would threaten their confiscation in what is a clear contradiction to the fundamental principles of the state. This bill is an assault on the freedom and independence of our churches, which have served and supported Christians in the Holy Land for two millennia.